نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين Respected teachers and dear audience, first of all, I greet you with the greeting of Islam, saying, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, in this gathering, I wish to talk in front of you on the topic of piety. Please listen to me and act upon it. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Holy Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين O believers in Allah, fear Allah and be with pious and true persons. Therefore, our duty is to take care of piety. We should fear Allah. We should fear Allah not only in mosque but outside of the mosque too. Not only among the friends but also inside the house. However, this is an uphill task and its reward is much. The piety's reward is plentiful. The piety is the base of all good deeds. Friends, Hakimul Ummat Hazrat Maulana Ashraf Ali Thanvi Rahmatullah Alayh said in his Tafsir Bayanul Quran, piety generates all good works. If anyone tries his best to follow whole deen, he should take oath to act upon piety. Thirdly, he would be able to follow whole deen. He should take oath to act upon piety. Thirdly, he would be able to follow whole deen. Friends, piety makes a man perfect. Piety makes a community perfect. That is why a man has to prefer piety. A society has to prefer piety. And the community has to choose piety. Allah has announced in the Holy Quran. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ Verily the most respectful among you is the person who has piety in himself more than anyone of you. Verily may Allah make us exceedingly pious. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا عَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ السلام عليكم ورحمة الله